Yo, what is going on, guys? Bobby here, and today we're switching it up actually quite a lot. So usually you guys know we're rocking that Brawl Stars content, but today at around 4:30 a.m., Rush Wars came out. So at the time of this recording, it's currently 8:05 a.m. Eastern. So I've played this game for a little bit more than 3 hours. I started a little bit late because I was about to go back to sleep because the game didn't come out at 4 when it was supposed to come out, and I got super disappointed. So I was about to go to sleep. And just as I was like drowsy and about to fall asleep, the game drops, everyone goes hype over it. So I'm waking up, I'm getting up, and I've been grinding since then. So for the past 3 hours, I've been grinding, and currently I am ranked first in the world. Yes, you see this right. It's super funny, we have Toma under us. So we have Bobby BS at number one, and the editor for Bobby's channel at number two in the world. We're just in VC grinding, and I'm really enjoying the game. So I was gonna make a video either way. Just to scope out if you guys like the game, if you don't like the game, see what the market is for this game on YouTube and kind of just check things out. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go into a few games. We're gonna do a couple attacks. I'm gonna show you guys my attack strategy, and then I'm gonna show you guys a couple defenses, some against Thomas, some against other top players. Now, attacks are way easier than defense, and mind you, I don't really have the best defensive strategy so far. I'm just doing what I face and what I think is OP when I face it. I kind of just threw it all together. I haven't really had time to do defense just because, you know, I just don't have the time because I'm busy pushing, getting those stars. So that being said, let's not waste more time. Let's get into it. So what I use is three shields. So I have level 7 shield. I bought two packs. I've spent $20 on the game. I bought two silver packs, and one of them contained the shields, and they're probably the most broken card in the game right now. I mean, they're just every bit OP. Everybody is using them in every type of composition, so I'm using them. And what you want to do with your three shields, or however many shields you can fit, is complement them with range. So I haven't tried the tank out yet, though I think it's probably pretty good. I'm using three of the pitchers. Now, I know Toma, who is second in the world, is using three, not the shields, sorry. I can't even find them here. Three of the bazookas. The bazookas are also really good, both really good options. And on top of that, we have the coach. And the coach is basically like a barbarian king if you played Clash Royale. So we're gonna go in. I'm gonna spend the. We're also using this, which is basically a rage spell. We're gonna just use this barb king type thing, the coach, just so you guys can see exactly how my strategy works. It's really, really easy to attack in this game. Super, super simple. So we're just gonna wait a little bit. Matchmaking doesn't take that much time, I'm assuming, because everyone has near the same cups. Give it a couple days and we're gonna see what happens to the cups, but I'm not really too sure. That was actually a pretty long matchmaking. So over here, we're gonna be going up against a person in my clan. I forgot to mention we also have the number one clan in the world. So we're gonna place this guy a little bit back like so and put our shields on the front, obviously self-explanatory, and then put our range in the back. So it's pretty simple. You're just gonna walk up like so. And I'm gonna hold down, so his special ability is a rage, so we're gonna use his original rage. And then when his rage runs out, we're gonna put our actual spell that is range. And you guys can see the tank locked onto our hero, which we really don't want. The tank has to go down immediately. Our hero literally carries, so you definitely wanna get the hero up for as long as you want. We have the three pitchers. Luckily, they're spread out, so the mortar can't do much. So we have also our shields over there. The shields are godly, they have so much HP, and they're just going in. So that's a really, really easy three. Star, three crown, whatever you want to call it. It took about 32 seconds against another top player, so it's really good. We're gonna go back to the home and we're just gonna run it again. So the same strategy, we're gonna use these three. Unfortunately, I'm gonna have to waste my gems just to show you guys the attacks. We're gonna do a couple more. Let's hop into the next game. So here we go, and we're actually gonna be matched up against Toma. Now, you can go to your next enemy, such as Clash Royale, just costs a little bit of gold. Personally, I don't want to do that because Toma has a really good defense system. I want to show you guys how he does it. So we like going from the top always. So we're going to put our troops on the top. With Toma's base, what happens is they actually funnel to the bottom because there's this wall right in the middle. Walls are really good for defense. You guys can see he's going to the bottom over there. That's really, really bad, as you don't want your troops to necessarily go for different things. You want to go on an all-out attack on everything. So again, we're going to use that rage. We want to use the rage right after the first, coach one, just because he gets his own rage right after. I don't think he's gonna be able to take out that Tesla over there. Maybe he will. It's gonna be really close. I don't think he's gonna be able to. And this is just gonna be a simple one star. Toma has a really, really good base. Once you get up here, it's getting a lot harder to defend. So it's gonna be a one star. Again, that's not bad. We sometimes three star Toma, we sometimes don't. You guys can see Toma's attacking us, that we gain three stars, so you gain stars for a defense. Then he three starred, then he got zero, then he got three. So it's kind of just cycling right now. Let's check the leaderboard, he's probably catching up since I'm doing a video. So let's do one more game. And again, same strategy, gonna try the same thing. Let's hop into the game and let's see what happens. Okay, so here we go into our next match. Now, this looks like a really OP map. I haven't faced it before, and this guy is, I've never seen him before. That's a really good base. We're definitely gonna look at something along the lines of that base. So we're just gonna search for another one just because that guy is super OP. I mean, that guy is just, you could tell by bases. I really haven't put in the time for my base. Maybe we'll create one during this video and I'll show you guys like kind of the strats, but the low key strat that's really good are walls. You really wanna get into them. Here's Toma again, so I'm just gonna skip it and look for somebody else. Someone that's fresh that you guys haven't seen. So anyways, walls are really important on defense. You can funnel them down one lane. A lot of troops can be used on defense. Personally, I don't use troops, I just use towers. I don't watch a lot of my defenses, so I'm kind of just gonna watch with you guys and check out what happens. We're gonna watch some of the ones I win, some of the ones I lose. So we faced this guy before, he's not bad. Again, you wanna go one way. We're gonna go through the top so that we can face his mortar and his whatever that is, tank sooner. So we're just gonna go down over here. Normal strategy. Gonna just be chilling. We're gonna use the rage a little bit later because that we have to wait for the mortar to reach us. That guy's a really good defender. He like does insane pierce damage. So again, just raging up, trying to get to these defenses as fast as possible. They're gonna be targeting on the defense. We're gonna be able to use our rage from the coach, and that's gonna be a really, really easy 3-star. So anyways, that's gonna be just a really, really quick video. That's basically my attack. Anyways, that's the strategy. You can substitute the bazooka for the pitcher, and I'm sure it's gonna do really well. You just wanna match the shield with the range. So with that being said, now we're gonna hop into the defense. So let's watch a couple replays. Sorry, I clicked on the leaderboards. So let's watch a couple that I won, and then we'll watch a couple that I lost. So we're gonna go over here. Let's go, just go this one, I guess. We're gonna replay this. And Toma's going in. So you guys can see he has three sets of shields and three sets of bazookas. The same strategy I have, just with the bazookas instead of the pitchers. And straight off the bat, we have the tanks going in, the mortar going in. The tanks are basically like body blockers doing a ton of damage. And the mortars just take everything out. I mean, the Tesla has a really good amount of HP. You guys can see the bazookas are going in. Luckily, my mortar's protected. What you guys want to do is 100% protect that mortar. The mortar is gonna be your best defensive troop, 100%. So make sure that is defended. Let's go back to the home, and we're gonna watch where he 3-starred us now. Because we have to learn from the mistakes. So he's gonna go in with the exact same strategy, but this time he has his gunner, which is his hero. And again, the same strategy, he's gonna deploy that heal. The heal definitely works really well against my base since everything is condensed. And if you can get that heal for a certain period of time, it's really, really easy. So he's going in over here. Again, my mortar isn't targeting the right people. The bazookas go in. That's gonna be really, really easy. So I think we're gonna construct a new base. I don't even know how to do this yet. Okay, so it's in the gold mine. Let's clear everything. I don't think we can change our map. So this is what we have cleared. So I think we're gonna put this right over here so it gets the entry level. We need to put our mortar 100% in the back. So the difference from it being here and here isn't that much. So we're gonna put it here because that makes it more protected. We're obviously gonna put this in. I think we're gonna put it, we'll put it over here, I guess. And this is when things get interesting. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put a couple walls right over there. We have two free walls left. So I think we're gonna put them, can we put them there? No, it's too high up, I think. Yeah, it's too high up for walls. So I guess we're just gonna put them like so. I mean, we can't really do much else. Actually, we can remove that, put it down here. Four free walls left. I think we'll put one here, one there, and then one here, one there. So completely block off every single point. We have 6 out of the 9 used right now, so we could go with a lot of different things. I haven't seen this in action yet, have I? No, I haven't, but it does look pretty OP. So I guess we're just gonna put this right over there, and we can fit in one troop. With the troop, I think we're gonna have to go with the gunner, just because the gunner does a lot of damage. So we're gonna save, we're gonna go home, and I mean, we're gonna do a couple more attacks. Toma probably passed me. Okay, he's tied with me at this point. We're gonna do one more attack and then we'll call it a video. So we're gonna go in one more time. Let's see what we do. Let's hop into it. Hopefully the matchmaking doesn't take that long, which I don't expect it to, since this game is really OP with the matchmaking. Okay, so we're gonna be locked up, or facing up against Super 619. So
I guess we'll go from the top just to get the 2-star guaranteed, or at least the 1, my bad. So we're going to start it off. Again, hopefully no one goes to the bottom, although it looks like 2 troops will. Okay, only 1 did, so that's fine. Waiting for stuff to lock on. Now we're going to use our rage. Our rage is going to end up getting used now, and we're just going to rage again. So only the mortars left and the and his gun or whatever it's called, but unfortunately we're able to take it out super fast. And there's just way too many units on the field. You can tell right off the bounce this wasn't that good of a base. There wasn't just enough there. So that's gonna end the video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I hope you guys learned some strategies. If you guys wanna see me continue making these types of videos, let me know in the comment section below. And if not, definitely we'll just head back over to Brawl Stars, continue doing Brawl Stars vids. I could do both, dependent on what you guys wanna see. Just let me know and I will pump it out. Anyways, that's gonna be it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace.